Albert Einstein famously dubbed quantum entanglement as spooky action at a distance, a phenomenon that still baffles the brightest minds today.
Let me think about it. Entanglement is this weird phenomena.
Quantum entanglement involves two particles, such as a pair of photons or electrons, that instantaneously influence each other no matter how far apart they are. Let's say you have two entangled balls in separate boxes. Before opening up the boxes to check their colors, each ball can be both red and yellow simultaneously, thanks to superposition existing in multiple states at once. When Mark opens up his box to find a yellow ball, Sarah's ball also turns yellow. If Mark sees a red ball, so does Sarah. Even if these balls are, say, billions of light years apart, define distance in our traditional understanding of space and time.
They are completely entangled, meaning you can treat them as a single object. You have to treat them like a single object.
So it's like that you have a twin and they're born together and they look the same. They have a lot of attributes that are related to each other. But then later in life, they might be separated far away, but then they still keep this relation throughout the years. And then they have a special way of communicating maybe with each other.
Albert Einstein found the concept of quantum entanglement troubling because it appeared to violate the principle of locality, which states that objects are only directly influenced by their immediate surroundings. Einstein suspected that the balls or particles were always either red or yellow from the beginning. Perhaps they had predetermined states we did not know until we observed them. However, the theoretical work of John Stuart Bell in the 1960s and later experiments in the 70s and 80s by other scientists proved Einstein wrong. A key to their confirmation involved observing entangled particles from different angles. If Mark decides to look at his ball from the side of the box, the ball would revert back to being in a state of superposition and have a 50% chance of being yellow and 50% chance of being red. Mark might find his ball yellow right now, even though the pair of balls had previously been red. If Sarah now switches to the side view as well, the color of her ball matches what Mark saw. The choice of the viewing angle changed the outcome of the experiment, so the information about color does not lie within one ball, but rather in the connection between the balls. Entanglement happens at subatomic and atomic levels, scales much smaller than can be seen with a standard microscope. Particles can become entangled by interacting directly, such as through electromagnetic forces, like two people who dance close together and their steps become synchronized. Entanglement can occur during the process of particle creation, where particles are produced as entangled pairs. Think of twins born holding hands. Or it can happen in the lab, where scientists use lasers, beam splitters, and other quantum operations to entangle particles like photons, atoms, and even molecules. In 2017, Chinese scientists led by Pin Jiawei achieved a groundbreaking feat by creating quantum entanglement using a satellite in orbit. Within the Mysia satellite, a laser directed at a light-altering crystal produced an astounding rate of 5.9 million entangled photon pairs per second. They were entangled in a manner ensuring their polarization states would be opposite when measured. The photons were sent down to two separate ground stations on Earth 1,200 kilometers apart. When the scientists measured the states of the photons, they were correlated far more than what random chance would predict, demonstrating quantum entanglement over unprecedented distances. Quantum entanglement was initially perceived as a theoretical concept in the abstract realm of quantum physics. But now it's thought to occur throughout nature. It could explain why plants are so efficient at converting sunlight into energy, a process known as photosynthesis. When sunlight reaches a plant, light particles called photons are absorbed by special molecules inside the plant cells called chlorophyll. Instead of hoarding the sunlight's energy, each chlorophyll molecule shares it with the other molecules. This shared energy, referred to as an exciton, suggests a fascinating aspect of photosynthesis. The distribution of excitons among the chlorophyll molecules may involve quantum entanglement. This could explain why the shared energy is able to appear in multiple locations simultaneously, finding the most efficient path to the plant's reaction center, where the energy is transformed into usable chemical energy for the plant. Quantum entanglement also helps explain the extraordinary properties of superconductors, materials that exhibit no electrical resistance. In conventional conductors like copper, the standard wiring found in homes, electrons encounter resistance as they collide with atoms and other electrons, leading to energy loss. It's like walking through a crowded room and bumping into other people. On the other hand, superconductors allow electricity to flow without any energy loss, no matter the number of twists and turns. The electrons form pairs that are thought to exhibit quantum entanglement, enabling them to move in a synchronized, coordinated manner. This perfect current flow creates a very strong magnetic field around the superconductor. This magnetic field can interact with external magnets, such as those in a magnetic levitating train, creating a powerful repulsive force that causes the train to levitate above the tracks. Yet, only a handful of maglev trains exist, because their superconductors require extensive cooling to function, a complex and expensive process. Imagine a future where scientists have unlocked the secret to superconductors that operate at room temperature. Such a discovery would reshape our world in ways that are hard to imagine. Eliminating energy loss in power lines could result in unprecedented efficiency. The advent of ultra-high-speed supercomputers, orders of magnitude faster than today's systems, could execute unthinkable calculations, significantly accelerating progress in artificial intelligence and scientific research. This is why quantum research, particularly the development of new quantum technologies, is a crucial area of focus for scientists.
The more things that we can entangle, and the more things that we can keep from getting disturbed by the rest of the world, we just keep winning and winning. And every year as we get better and better and better, we're starting to do things which are almost, you would have considered them magic just 50 years ago.
This once spooky phenomenon is now recognized as a fundamental part of reality, challenging our understanding of the universe. Another fascinating quantum phenomenon that puzzles scientists is the double-slit experiment, where light particles act differently depending on whether they're being observed. When they're not being watched, they act like waves. When they are being observed, they behave like particles, suggesting that the mere act of observing can alter their behavior. I covered that in depth in another video that I linked in my description. If you're eager to unravel more mysteries in science and dive deeper into STEM, I highly recommend Brilliant. Brilliant is the best way to learn math, science, data science, and computer science through engaging, hands-on lessons on their website and app. Brilliant's interactive math courses are especially popular and essential to understanding quantum mechanics. When you join Brilliant, you'll be matched with content that fits your experience level, whether you're a beginner or you're ready to write programs for a quantum computer. Their scientific thinking courses are also one of my favorites, as you learn through physical insight. This puzzle that challenges you to predict the final light intensity after it passes through 5 filters is one of thousands of lessons that exercise your critical thinking and problem-solving skills. Brilliant is free for you to try out for 30 days. Just scan my custom QR code on your screen. My link is also in the description, brilliant.org/newsthink. If you're one of the first 200 people to sign up with my custom link, you'll get a 20% discount on Brilliant's annual premium subscription, which gives you access to all of their offerings. Thanks for watching. For Newsthink, I'm Cindy Pom.